Hello everyone, I am Vamik Khan, currently pursuing VLLB from Vivekananda College of Law, Aligarh. Currently, I am also legal intern at Lexis and Company Law Firm. So my presentation topic is Justice Delayed, Justice Denied. So many chief justices, judges of the Supreme Court, the High Courts, the law ministers, the law commission, the media and the great writers and thinkers have all lamented over the delay in the dispensation of justice. The inordinate delay in the provision of relief amounts to be virtual. Denial of any relief found in a number of cases. If a case of compensation in a motor car accident case is decided after 10 years, when the career of the children is already spoiled for want of money. If a case of property is decided after the death of the plaintiff, what is the value or use of such a decision? Seen in the real or practical sense, the courts or the government or the procedures are the real culprits for the sufferings of the plaintiff. Instead of saying that justice delayed is justice denied, we should say delayed justice is the injustice. Millions of cases are pending in various courts, tribunals and commissions for disposal. None can predict about the minimum or maximum time for disposal of any kinds of cases by dying courts, whether it is a civil case or a criminal case or a case of claims of compensation to a victim of road accidents, train accident or accident at a workplace. Consumers are battling for justice for the wrongs done to them by the manufacturer or a public utility service like electricity board or railways or a hospital. There are cases of under trials who have been distinguishing in jail for years together waiting for trial. Most of the under trials are spending a long time in prison than the conviction would warrant. Is it justice? Slow progress of cases in courts and operation of the system of bail to the disadvantage of the poor and illiterate prisoners or are responsible for the pathetic plight of these forgotten souls who continue to suffer all the hardship of incarceration although their guilt is yet to be established. Said Justice Anand. Recently, the National Human Rights Commission expressed its grave concern over the under-trial prisoners and suggested regular holding for special courts in jails and they are monitoring by the Chief Justice, Senior Judges of High Courts. The Commission has found that many under trials are languishing in jails even after being granted bail because they are unable to raise sureties. Mr. Justice A.S. Anand had suggested that these cases be reviewed to consider their suitability for release on personal bonds, especially in cases when they are the first offender and the punishment is also less than 2 to 3 years. There has been no difference of opinion over the desirability of the quicker dispensation of justice and dealing with the arrears of cases pending in various recounts. Several tangible solutions were tried and implemented over the preceding decades to reduce or lessen the pendency in the courts. To lessen the burden of ordinary court, different types of courts like consumer courts, the administrative tribunals, family courts, lok adalats and fast track courts have been set up in recent years. Though with the setting of these courts, a number of cases have since been disposed of, still millions of cases are pending in various courts. The litany of woes caused by the delay in the administration of justice is disastrous. A layman does not want to understand anything or any reason for the delay in the administration of justice. He just wants to understand that he has the right to get the justice and that too within a reasonable time. When an aggrieved sorrow does not get justice within a reasonable time, then all is suffering and hardship because of such delay are like a punishment inflicted on him for no fault of his. Delay justice is the biggest cause of prevalent corruption in the country. Many political leaders are enjoying the benefits of being ministers while a number of cases are pending against them. Are our courts not their accomplices? Why are such cases which affect the governance of the country not taken up on a priority basis? Why cannot all the hurdles in the finalization of such cases be removed and the lame excuses were given by such politicians for delaying the cases rejected? Is it unimaginable how much loss our nation is suffering from an ethical and moral point of view because of the delay in disposing of the cases? An innocent person is the worst affected and unfortunate who has to take shelter of the courts for getting justice. Nobody seems to have a remedy for his worries and frustration. Such sufferings and hardships make him to conclude that justice delays justice denied. So this is all about justice delay, justice denied. If you have any question related to this, please mention in the comment box. And this video is not for any kind of promotion or एडवर्टीजमेंट एक्सेट्रा एक्सेप्ट। प्लीज लाइक दिस वीडियो, सब्सक्राइब द लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी लॉ फर्म चैनल।